foul caught it with a foot. The post dropped under the top rope, bounces back into the ring. Dutch Mantell quickly picks him up in the air. Body slam. Mantell to the rope. Off with the arm and has his body right on top of Coco. Count is three.
He got it.
And that is it. We have a new TV champion. Coco Ware, who was undefeated for championship defenses of that TV title, has just been defeated by Dutch Mantell. Dutch Mantell wins the TV title from Coco Ware in 5 minutes, 11 seconds of action, and it was all action.
Boy, he nailed him with that elbow. He came right across the ring. And he... Yeah. So Dutch Mantell in his first appearance in a long, long time on championship wrestling comes through and defeats the champion, Coco Ware, not easy. That one extra count on him that made the difference. And then it's 5 minutes and 11 by 11. Dutch Mantell will have his name put down as our new championship wrestling TV champ.
Tough loss for Coco in there, but don't think he's going to be gone. By golly, I'll tell you what, this guy's a scrapper.
So Mantell, the new champion, and we're going to take time out. We'll be back with action in just a moment.
Around Madisonville Saturday tonight, that is. Big action returns to Madisonville. Get out there and watch that championship wrestling action. Now, Tuesday night, that's right, back on Tuesday night. Next Tuesday in the Louisville Gardens, it'll be a big night of action that'll have a Southern Tag title match, an entire all-star card, and the final event is going to have Jerry the King Lawler and Giant Frazier, the big plowboy, going against the Universal Heartthrob, Austin Idol, and Dirty Dutch Mantell with Jimmy Hart at ringside.
You know the reason for this match, Lance, and so does everybody in Louisville, Kentucky. Let me just give you a little background, a little rundown on what's taking place here. Austin Idol is a low-life scum, and he's sick upstairs. I knew it before, but now he proved it last week. He knows that in his wildest dreams, on his best day, he doesn't have a chance in the ring with the King, and he showed his true colors. First of all, he put a mask over his face, pulled a big charade, came in here, and put the plaque over my head on TV. But we had a little match after that. He knew he didn't have a chance in that. So he tells Dutch Mantell, you wait back in the wings, you watch this match, because I can't handle the King by myself. And when he gets me in trouble, he hits the ring. Well, that's exactly what happened. Well, you made your little plans, and it worked out pretty well so far. So I can't fight, folks. I just thought I made myself a little phone call. And I got a hold of a man that we haven't always been the best of friends. But that's not really what I need to handle two jerks like you. I need somebody that can hand out a whipping, and I know this man can because I've been on the wrong end of a lot of them. Plowboy Frazier, 460 pounds, and he's coming in here with one thing in mind, and that's to do exactly what I want to do with you, Idol, and you, Mantell, and that's get you the hell out of Louisville and get you the hell out of my life, because I'm going to take care of both of you scums if it's the last thing I do, and I'm going to start up there this Tuesday night. Hart, I hope you get your face close to the ring, because I'll re-break that jaw of yours.
Louisville will be rocking Tuesday night at the Garden.
Okay, back to the ring, Dave, in the introduction.
All right, this will be a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match from Memphis, Tennessee. On the right of your screen at 190 pounds, Tom Maley is going against him. 270 pounds, the Dream Machine, with his manager, Jimmy Hart. This is a one-fall, 15-minute time limit match. Referee is Jerry Calhoun.
Okay, referee Calhoun telling Hart to get out of the ring, and bang, we're off and running at bell time, and here we go, Tom Maley. Started looking better, but he is against a very large Dream Machine. Dream right away on top of him. Bang, both hands that time. Nailed him with a double chop. And Tom Maley never had a chance to get started as the Dream really about 2 seconds.
you, God, from now on, when the Dream Machine gets in the ring with anybody, it don't make no difference. Where's Lawler, Sunday Rick, anybody, it don't make no difference. You see it, Jimmy Hart, you see it, Lance Storm, you see it, Dave Brown, that's what they're going to get right there.
Dream Machine.
Time on it was 51 seconds, and he could have done it in 35.
Yeah.
But,
as a matter of fact, he nailed Maley right before the bell rang and got him going, and Tom never had a chance in it. So the winner, the Dream Machine. We got a big eight-man tag action match with Dundee Rick, Hogan, Gilbert, going against the Bounty Hunters, the Angel, and Ali Hassan. And we'll see it all in just a moment. They got good company with the Big Angel, and Ali Hassan makes the fourth man on this side of the ring.
Okay, Dave, we're ready for the introduction.
Oh, well, that's mass of humanity up there.
Yes, sir. It'll be an expiration of time match, an eight-man tag team match, introducing at a total weight of 1,000 pounds. On the left of your screen, the Bounty Hunters, Jerry and David Novak, and from Portland, Oregon, the Angel, from the Middle East, Ali Hassan. Manager of the Bounty Hunters, Jimmy Kinn, is in the corner over there, too. Going against him at a total of 867 pounds. From Union City, Tennessee, Coco Ware. From Lexington, Tennessee, Eddie Gilbert. From Hendersonville, Tennessee, Tommy Rich. And from Australia, Bill Superstar Dundee. Eight-man tag team match. It goes to the expiration of time. And good luck to referee Jerry Calhoun.
Beautiful sentiments in there because of that group, and particularly the Dundee and Rich and the Bounty Hunters, who really have no love with each other. You can better believe it's going to be a very difficult match to referee. It may be even a difficult match to spectate, Dave. I'm not sure about that. Ring it. And there we go.
The bell sounds.
Almost.
Underway. Big Jerry Novak of the Bounty Hunters starts, and Eddie Gilbert for his two. He steps right over, drop kicks the Bounty Hunter, and Eddie Gilbert looking good as we get underway with this eight-man tag team match. Lance mentioned it might be difficult to comment on this match, and that's true for one reason, is because the 1,000-pound weight is over here in the corner that partially blocks our view. So we're having to look around the Angel and the Bounty Hunters and Ali Hassan. Eddie Gilbert into the rope. Rolls down the Bounty Hunter. Shoulders down. Count of one is all he gets. Eddie, good move. Boy, he put the shoulders down. But could only hold the big Bounty Hunter, Jerry Novak, down for a count of one. That's David Novak in there. David Novak of the Bounty Hunters with a headlock over close to the corner. Bill Dundee was kind of looking at him like he was going to take a shot at him if he got a little closer. So the Bounty Hunter left the corner. He makes the tag on the Big Angel. Dundee unloads on the Angel as he was over into the rope. Eddie Gilbert went for a quick cover, did not get a three count. Tommy Rich wants the tag. He gets it. And then Tommy, Wildfire Rich, over for a shot at the Bounty Hunters. Cover on the Angel, but the Angel rolls him right off before the referee can start the count. Rich and Bill Dundee, not at all happy with the Bounty Hunters situation anyway. So Tommy
used the opportunity to take a shot at them while he was in the neighborhood. Tommy Rich now against Ali Hassan. Both of them using the rope. Tommy sets himself. Wow. The forearm. He had a flying start. He let it go. Cover. Count is one.